Welcome to the Trash Picture Show. Just after the success of the Lord of the Rings trilogy, Peter Jackson was tasked with the monumental project of doing the remake of King Kong. The 1930s classic was loved and cared about by many, and was Jackson up to the task? I actually think he was. The movie was breathtaking, it was cool, it was awesome, and it had fantastic emotion, in no small part to Andy Serkis. Serkis, who had already proven himself the king of mocap, played Gollum in the Lord of the Rings trilogy. He took it a step further. For his preparation to be King Kong, he travelled to Africa and studied gorillas in the wild. He wanted to encompass what it was like to be an ape, and he done a magnificent job. It wasn't just him though, the rest of the cast do amazing, admirable jobs at their roles. Adrian Brody plays Jack Driscoll, playwright turned adventurer who has to rescue the woman he loves, Ann Darrow, played by Naomi Watts. In the prior 1930s movie, Ann Darrow was a screaming damsel in distress. However, Watts gives Ann Darrow a spirit and a spunk that no one can deny. She doesn't take crap, she looks after herself, and she even stands up to Con. Rounding out the rest of the cast, you have Jack Black as Carl Denham. Not someone you'd call a villain, but definitely a morally flexible individual. He tricks a lot of people into coming to Skull Island, and you're wondering, does he care about the crew of the Venture, or does he just care about making his movie? The rest of the supporting cast is pretty cool. Jamie Bell and Colin Hanks are two of the other crew members who are kind of stuck in this kind of struggle for survival on Skull Island against so many predators. The cool thing about Skull Island is it feels like an actual place. The prior Con movie, while fantastic for the time, doesn't feel like a solid ecological environment. This place does, with plants, insects, flora, fauna all over the place. A lot of it was cut, but luckily enough, Peter Jackson released the deluxe edition. Not only do we see the Apatosaur stampede due to the Velociraptors, but we see a Triceratops-like creature attack the men when they get to the other side of the gate. We also see the men try to cross a river on a raft, only to be attacked by a Pteranodon, a weird prehistoric fish creature. It's amazing, and of course, you can't forget the epic battle between Khan and three V-Rexes. I love this movie. This movie was awesome. I think a lot of people forget it or brush it to the side, but it is a wicked adventure. It is, that's a solid, cool adventure. If I had any critique about it would be the running time, especially on board the Venture. With movies with the likes of Alien and other kind of crew of people, they want you to get to know the characters that when they start dying, you care about them. But I think it lingers a bit too long on the ship. We get it, we care about these people, they want us to like them. Also, Circus appears as one of the crew members, the cook, Lumpy, if I'm not mistaken, and he does a fantastic performance in that. It is an amazing movie, and I would not kind of just discredit it as another kind of hashback remake. It is cool, it is filled with action, adventure, and a lot of heart. A couple of tie-in things came out for it. First up, there was the video game, which came out in multi-platforms, both Xbox 360, PlayStation 2, and PC. Essentially, you play two roles, one of Jack Driscoll trying to survive on Skull Island against dinosaurs and other weird invertebrate monsters, and second, you play Con, the king of Skull Island. You fight different dinosaurs and creatures to protect Ann Darrow across the savage land. The next thing that I have, which I was really happy with getting, was this. It's The Natural History of Skull Island. This is a fantastic book. It's done like an actual zoological study of Skull Island, and it was a way for the Weta art department to feature some of the creatures that did not make it into the movie. And it is kind of sad because they done some fantastic art and design. If I show you, That's the creature that attacks the men on the raft. There's some other monsters and dinosaurs. There is a triceratops-like creature which attacks when they go to the other side of the gate there. And it's a beautiful book. The artwork is amazing, and it just shows the intimate detail that went in to making such a movie. It is amazing, it is awesome. And also the Carnictus, I actually really thought that was cool with this book. It explained that the Carnictus, that kind of slug creature at the bottom of the pit, is actually an intestinal parasite from a V-Rex that has evolved. Stuff like that is awesome. It shows that the love and care that went into this movie, it shows that Weta put 110% into this movie, and for Peter Jackson, it was a labor of love. If you're a fan of monster movies, if you're a fan of classic movies, if you're a fan of Lord of the Rings, check out Peter Jackson's King Kong. And if you can, try get the extended edition. My name's Martin. This has been the Trash Picture Show. Like, subscribe, and leave a comment. And yeah, have a good one. Take care. Bye now.